Well, my name is Joan Belmar. I am a visual artist. I was born in Santiago de Chile, and I lived there until I was 23 years old. In Chile, I studied graphic design, and after graduate, I realized that it was not what I wanted to do. And I left Chile, and I traveled to Spain. And in Spain, I get in touch with other artists and influence for Spanish artists, Tapies and Clavé and many others, Miró. And since then, I start to paint. When Christopher Addison came to my studio, he asked me what was the biggest painting that I ever paint. And I told him, so he told me double of that. So that's double. And it was a challenge for me because my studio is okay, but it's not big enough. So it was an interesting process to move the painting, and also I painted the floor. So it was kind of tricky. This exhibition is titled Chords because I was playing with elements, technically elements and images that I used before in my work. And I'm trying to create a composition from using all these elements.
We're finally there. This is the last painting, and I hope that you agree, as we do, that this complements the space of the rest of the paintings, because yes. I think that we've got something for everyone. Shall we hang it up?
Yes, let's do it.
You go first?
I go first.
Done.
The reaction of the people was wonderful, and I love how each person see different things in the paintings, how they're related to chords, and also I like the fact that each person had different favorite piece, which made me happy. The process is fundamental in the work. I start dyeing the canvas. I don't gesso, I just dye the canvas. And since then, I start to develop thicker layers of painting until reach the bold blacks or blues that come in the front of the painting. This painting is called Liberto. It's about freedom. And it's a piece that is looking to find the balance using these different elements. And I usually paint people, artists use diptychs in a vertical way. And I want to use it in a horizontal way, so it was a different approach. This is a small canvas, it's called a small canvas. And I play a little more with the color. I was trying to play with this range of colors, and also I use a polymer, which is an acrylic that could create the effect of wax. I will tell you one little thing about this piece, and it's about childhood has been something very important for me, because it's the time, right, and something that we lose and we cannot come back. So I worked in series before where I use toys, like typical toys, and here you can see, even though it's abstraction, but it's, how do you call this?
A top.
Yes, spinning top. Do you see it now? This piece is called Chords number one, black, and it's a painting on paper. And I was trying to play with the concept of diversity and this kind of universal feelings, and of course everything in a more abstract way. I think what I realized that I'm working in layers, so some of them are transparent, so I want you to see what happened behind, and sometimes are mistakes, but I leave them there, so I want you to see them. And meanwhile, the painting advances, the thickness of the painting increase. So as when I finish, as you see the black, it's the black wash that make this void circles.
I also was really interested, and maybe you can tell me more about this. I see a lot of these lines as being stitched, as being, you know, the way you would run a needle and thread. Is that part of your own experience with sewing? Did you have someone in your household who sewed, or did you ever sew?
No. The lines with the stitches, as you say, correspond to the idea that everything is circular. Mm-hmm. Even lines are part of a circle.
So that when stitching does this, it's creating the halves of the circle.
Exactly.
But phased. Uh-huh. So you have one half phase, one half phase, one half phase, exactly. and so on. Strategically, what we like to do is to think in the way that a collector might. What can we do to put work on the wall that will encourage a collector to take that work home? In your case, since we're new in this relationship, we want to get as many different collectors as possible collecting your work. And I think that we've got enough range in the show. I know how hard you worked on it, but I think we have enough range so that it appeals to first-time collector who only wants to spend a small amount of money, and someone who's got an hotel where this would be a signature piece. Part of this is our bet that other people will see what we see in the work. Part of it is that I haven't seen an artist who had these many subtle surfaces on pure painting in a really long time.
So I feel that as an artist, I've been changing. My work has changed, and the geographical region has changed too. Language has changed, but I'm thinking that artists, we are looking for something, and the point is never find it, because then you are always working, looking for that thing.